You might be asking yourself, who is that majestic creature in front of me? And it is I, Daniel. And today, I want to show you how to automate emails using SAS. Now, I originally wrote this program to help automate the emails being sent from the Department of Public Health to the health facilities that we worked with. This was extremely important during the pandemic as tons of data was coming into the state. The state needed to be able to then validate that data quickly and give back to the health facilities about their data quality if need be. And so I'm going to show you what that code looked like, only this one is going to be tailored towards the automotive industry and specifically recalls in the automotive industry, because it's another area this code can also be applied to. As you know, recalls can happen quite a bit in the automotive industry, but sometimes they can be life-threatening. Specifically, a couple years ago, there was an airbag recall that hit a lot of manufacturers. We're going to use that example when we're using this code today. So let's go ahead and take a look at the code and see how this is broken up. So we're going to first be building our paths, our live name paths. I like to use call simputs to build date variables, date macro variables that I use throughout my codes. So this is one way I help to automate my programs. Specifically, this code is broken up into essentially three macros. The first macro creates a folder for each car manufacturer that we're wanting to look at today. It's going to be over here on the left-hand side when we run the code. And then the second macro that we're going to be running is the report macro. And this is going to build an Excel report for each manufacturer, and it's going to put it within the folder that we built previously. And then finally, we're going to send out an email to these car manufacturers, letting them know how many models that may be impacted by this hypothetical airbag recall. So let's get into this. As you can see, I got my setting up my dates here at the top. Then we're going to go ahead and get into bringing in the data. So this is when we're going to call in the car manufacturer data. And I'm only going to be looking at a couple. Oops. Looks like I need to run the first part of the code. All right, here we go. First, got to run the live names first. So we're going to run the live names first, and then we're going to pull in the data. All right. So I have it filtered for Ford, Toyota, Kia, Acura, Audi, and BMW. I have no idea if these actually had recalls for airbags. We're just going to use these as an example. So let's go ahead and run this code, and this time it'll run. So as you can see, the data's in there, and for this example, I went ahead and at the end of the code, I just created a model count, meaning I'm just counting the number of models that each manufacturer has. So Acura has 7 models, as you can see here on the right-hand side. Going back to the code, we've got our data in. Here is the folder macro. As you can see, it's saying new directory, and I'm creating it. And I'm saying that I want for each make within the data, I'm going to say I want a folder built for them. And I'm going to direct it towards the path that I have assigned up in the, at the top of the code. So that's the first macro. The second macro is right here, and this is the report generator. This is going to build an Excel spreadsheet for every single manufacturer that I've designated in the first table. And it's going to build an Excel spreadsheet for all the records that that manufacturer has. So I'm going to have make model, count the models as model count, and I'm going to filter it to that make. So this is the second macro, and it's going to build those Excel spreadsheets that I was talking about earlier. All right, and then here is the how I'm going to call both of those macros. I'm designated it by the make, and I'm using only the first time that make appears. So this is really important when you're running these macros, especially since you're doing iterative processing like this. That means that you want the first one, in this scenario, the first time the make appears. So let's say, for example, Ford appears 10 times. I'm saying the first time it appears, I'm going to create a report for it instead of having 10 different reports. So this is really important. I'm consolidating all the data into one report versus, let's say, 10. And then this is how I'm calling those macros. I'm using the call execute, and I'm using cats, and this is the different macros that I'm calling and the macro variables within them. All right, let's go ahead and run these two macros and see what happens. Okay, perfect. So it worked. We've got our folders here, Acura, Audi, BMW, Ford, and Kia. And then within those folders, I've got a report, one that says Acura, May 16, 2021. I like to put the dates on my reports just so if this code runs multiple times or you can completely delete all these folders if you need to, it'll keep building them back. So it'll build the folder again. If you have this running on a schedule and you were to run this many times in a row, let's say 7 days a week, it would have reports for every single day and they wouldn't get confused because they'd have the dates on them. So that's important. I like to have my reports organized like that and separated in folders. We've got our reports now. Let's go ahead and take a look at the report actually. So just to see, they're super simple. Nothing fancy, just a quick little Excel spreadsheet that says the make, Acura, the model, all the models, and then the number of models that we have. We've got a sum of 7 models or a count of 7 models. Let's go ahead and get into the next part of this. Now we've got the email macro, and this is the meat and potatoes of this code because this is really what helps to automate the emails being sent. If this was just the email code and not, it wasn't within a macro, this wouldn't be able to be automated and to send out mass emails. So this is really important. That's a really key thing to remember is that putting code into macros like this helps to automate it. Right here, we've got a couple different options that are on this code. You can use the to. This is the email that you want it sent to. Typically, what I like to do with this code is I like to have a separate email list in Excel that I join in, then use it to, from the table that I'm calling from, put the emails in with that. So just make sure when you're sending to, if you're sending one email to multiple recipients, just make sure you have the double quotations around each email that you're going to use. I typically have a separate macro for the email list. So I'll have backup 1, backup 2, backup 3 as my emails. You can say where this email is coming from, the sender, you can do BCC, CC, reply, the importance. This is a good one. If it's something that you really want seen, which, you know, a car manufacturer would want to know if their airbags aren't working. So we want to say that this is high importance. And we can also say the sensitivity, so confidential. There's the subject. I like to use macro variables in my subject, in the body of my email to help to customize the emails so it doesn't just look like a mass generated email that doesn't really apply. This is very, you can get very customized with these emails. And then finally, I'm going to attach the Excel spreadsheets that we built earlier in the second macro so that the car manufacturer can see exactly what models might be impacted by this faulty airbag. I'm just going to say in the body of my email, National Highway Traffic Safety Administration has identified the number of models that have potentially faulty airbags. If you're sending emails in Base SAS or SAS EG, you're going to want to use the SMTP option. And that's this code here. I'll go ahead and highlight it. This option here designates the system's SMTP, and you're going to do your email right here, your email address, and then this is your email hostname. This would be found either in the command line, you type in nslookup, and you can find your host domain name, and then usually it's email port 25. Otherwise, if you can't find it, I would definitely recommend talking to your IT department if you have one and trying to find it through them. All right, super simple, nothing too fancy, but it gets the point across. I'm going to call this macro the same way that I called the other two, and I'm going to call it by the first make. So I don't want 10 reports for Ford to go out. I only want one. So it's all a cumulative report, just one sent out. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. All right. Perfect. So no errors. That's great. And we've got each one of these. You can see the data that's being sent out. Here's the email that's being sent out. And so we've got one for each one of the manufacturers that we identified. And let's go back to the code. Now, I set this code up originally to be set up on a schedule. For me personally, I like to be notified when I have an automated code that it's running. I want to know when it's done running that, and if it's run successfully. So I like to add a text message at the end of my code to then notify me that the code is run. So that's what this is right here. It's just a quick little message saying this report has run. That's it. It'll be super simple text message. Now, when you're sending a text message via SAS, SAS that you want to have the, you have the phone number, and then it sends through an email server. So you need to have the @, and then if it's Verizon or AT&T.com. So you need to have the carrier. So just keep that in mind if you're using text message. So let's go ahead and run this. We should hear my watch chime in a little bit. That my code is run. All right, and so now that the code is all run, should be getting my text message soon. Oh, there it is. Great. And here are the emails that have been sent. So you can see that there's the Excel spreadsheet, the macro that I was using to send the number of models impacted are showing up in the body of the email. That's great. And you can see for Kia, there's one for Ford, there's one for BMW, Toyota. This is how you would send out your messages at mass to really get the point across quickly without having to send a lot of manual emails. Well, I hope you learned a lot from this video today. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down in the comment section below. Make sure you smash that like button. Also, subscribe to the SAS Users channel for more awesome content. Thank you. Bye.